things for the store. You have only one key.
What are you opening?
And he said, I will take you in the best ship, the best shuttle. Does your God want what you have stolen to come bring to him as a tithe? You want to choose me, and you think you're going to bring a big tithe to the Lord. You
need
to choose me, and you think the Lord will be happy with you. He's a God of order. He can never bless that sacrifice. If when you go and struggle there in wrong ways, he will not bless you. He never blessed Saul with his cattle. So they were fatted cows. He never blessed them. So today, I've rejected you as king. Hallelujah. He said, from today, I've rejected you as king. I gave you a chance to repent. I gave you good things. I showed you the best side of me. I'll come back to them. You have kept that list of your friends under your pillow. Yes, God is going to answer me. God, I will strike off the rest and I'll keep one. This is under your pillow. This is in your handbag. This is in your past. What are you doing with your God? So for the rest of our God. Marry you with somebody else. He can't share you when you are still living in evil. Denounce all the Americans. Destroy all the Americans. Don't prefer to please people.
To please
your God. He chose you. And you can continue reading first somewhere. Continue reading this chapter. You saw how God rejected Saul. I've rejected you today. Because you never did my work. We have seen how God has been giving instruction. There is the presence of God in you. There is the presence of God in you. You must continue with that presence of God. So don't let him come and destroy you. Because the presence of God is within us. As I move, I move with the presence of God. Children of God, you have got the presence of God in you. Don't let the Lord reject you. These are the last days. Do what is right.
To college too.
The Lord loved his soul. He anointed him. As was the God who rejected him. The Lord can reject us. When we do things that are contrary to what has told us, he's the God of order. Our God loves us. He wants us to move by him. He's the God of order. Don't allow the Lord to destroy you. Don't do things which are contrary. Wherever the presence of God is, there is that glory. Even when the disciples were in the water moving in that ark, in the boat, when they were hit by the storm, they were shouting. They thought we were going to die. They were going to die. They didn't know that the presence of God was there. When they woke up, they said, why should you be of little of little faith?
Yes,
how can you be destroyed when the whole presence is here? You are the only you. There is no another you. God designed you for his own glory. Special designed for himself. He wants to use you. He loves you. He says, come back to me. I shall try to destroy you. Come back to me. I designed you in my own image. Nobody is like you. He cannot be you. You are only you. So allow the presence of the Lord to be shown in your life. Today, I've come to tell you, allow the presence of the Lord to be shown in your life. Let the people of the world see the Lord is love. In whatever you do, in your office, let the presence of the Lord be seen. When you are talking, let their words show the presence of God. Let the people see the glory of God. Let the people know that you're a different person. You're a child of God. Specially designed for his work. Specially designed for his glory. You are not a little person. You are He can't fetch your mantle. What do we read in Exodus 14:24? He brought confusion to enemies of the Israelites. When they were following him, the Egyptians, he threw confusion. The children of Pharaoh. All of you, I know that the Lord remains in you. He dwells in you. But what have you been doing in your life? Has your mouth been giving glory to God? In a dead that mouth that has been backbiting, your thoughts, I get the thoughts of God. I'm not repenting. When you have blessed yourself, call upon the presence of God. Call the presence of God. Come into our life. I know he loves us. He separated us from the world. He still loves us. And he work with us. He's the same God. Start repenting for God. Go into the presence of God. Introduce yourself. Show him who you are. I know we are not all worthy. I'm here today, this morning. I've been listening to your word, Jehovah. I am morning here. I know that many things that have been contrary to what you have told me to do. Things that have not missed you. Things that have not given you joy. Things that have not missed people. I'm ashamed of your name that you have moved. I'm ashamed of your name that you have said to me. They have went and where is my God? They have looked for my God, they can't see him. Who are the Christians of West Church? Who are the people of West Church? They can still compromise. They compromise with sin. They are behaved by the people of the world. We are serving God, but we are serving the world also. There are these things that are not right with God. Check yourself. You have not given him reverence. You have not given him the place that he deserves. You have not given him all the good things that you have seen.
Presence in my life. Come to me, Jehovah King.
astray. Don't let me go astray. Come, Lord. He says, let us go to his dwelling place. Let's worship him at his footstool. Thank you, Jesus.